boy has 8 cases of dengue that have been acquired overseas in areas that are known to be spots with the virus. Joining us now with some tips on how to protect yourself as well as your loved ones when you are traveling this summer is Dr. Nathan Tan with the Department of Health. Aloha and good morning, Nathan. Thank you so much for stopping by with us.
Aloha, Sam. Mahalo, Sam and KHON for having us here to speak about dengue.
So what is dengue?
Dengue is a viral infection that's transmitted through the bite of an infected mosquito from an infected person to another person. It can cause a infection in people. Typically, it's a mild infection that may last about 7 days and might include fever, chills, aches, bone pain, headache, pain behind the eye, even nausea. Most of these infections will be mild, but in some cases, they will be severe. People can be hospitalized. In very rare conditions, people can die from this. And so that's what we're concerned about.
Yeah, even mild cases sounds like something you do not want to get. Right. Do we have dengue here in Hawaii?
Yes. So dengue is not established here in Hawaii. Every year, we have cases that occur from travelers that go to areas where dengue is present, and they come back with the infection. This year, we've had 8. However, we do have the mosquitoes that can transmit the infection. And in the past, there have been outbreaks of dengue, and that's what we're working hard to prevent.
Yeah, that is the concern, right? Where is it found? People who are out traveling, where should they be concerned about?
So dengue is found in places where it's warm and typically wet, but it can occur in the Americas, Central and South America, the Caribbean, Africa, parts of the Middle East, and then in our own area, parts of Southeast Asia and the Pacific, and surrounding Pacific Island countries as well.
Yeah, so a lot of summer destinations that folks will be traveling to. What advice can you give people that are going to travel to some of those areas this summer to protect themselves?
Yeah, so it's really important to, first of all, plan ahead. 4 to 6 weeks, think about looking at the area that you may be traveling to. Look online or speak with your physician about the area and determine what the health risks are associated. CDC provides information for travelers that are going overseas about the health risks associated with the countries that they may be visiting. And then for areas that may, if you're visiting an area where dengue may be established, take steps to prevent bites from mosquitoes. So that would be using or packing and bringing along an EPA registered insect repellent, or packing clothes that are appropriate. So long sleeve clothes, long pants, and particularly ones that are kind of loose fitting. We don't want ones that are tight and thin. Those mosquitoes can bite right through that. Mm-hmm. So that's really important. And then think about where you're going to be staying to as well. So an accommodation that's indoors, that has screens that you can use. If you're not going to be doing that, you're going to be outside. Think about bringing a mosquito net to prevent bites from mosquitoes while you're sleeping.
Yeah, some stuff that we can practice too at home in areas where we do have a lot of water. I was on the Big Island a few weeks ago. My family lives up there. Very wet area above on Hualalai, tons of mosquitoes. So I got bit and I learned the lesson with the tight clothing. Yeah, you got to wear something a little bit more loose. What other measures are taking place here in Hawaii to prevent dengue?
Yeah, so here in Hawaii, what we can do is just take steps to reduce the mosquitoes in the areas that we live in. So go around your property, take a look at areas where there may be standing water. Hmm. So little cups that might be left out, rain buckets, even plants that can collect water like bromeliads. Take a look in those areas and see if there's any standing water poured out. Mosquitoes need places to breed, and they need water. And if we can reduce that, eliminate that, then we'll really cut down on the mosquito population and the chance that we'll get bitten by a mosquito and spread mosquito-related diseases.
Yeah, something that we can all do to help prevent the spread of dengue.
Absolutely.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Nathan. Appreciate you joining us this morning and sharing all these wonderful tips.
Thank you so much.